You can edit photos here, you can edit dates, you can add tags, and we'll talk more about that. An album is sort of like a category. It's an album. And there's sets and groups, and we won't get into all of that. What we're looking at here is just a scrolling timeline of all my content, all 2,042 items, in the order that they were uploaded. You can search for an individual photo. And this also lets you look at any photos that don't have a tag on it, if you want to add a tag to them. We won't get into sets right now. That'll slow us down. Gives you a way to look at content uploaded by date. And then albums. I've created a number of albums to group my photos. My Land Rover, Halloween parties, my time at Learfield, a trip to Malaysia, so on and so forth. Okay, and we'll drill into how this works a little bit more. Albums and collections. So a collection is a group of albums. So I've got under the collection for Kennett, my hometown, I've got several albums, Basement Diaries, Halloween Party, so on and so forth. But I mean, you can see, you can read to illustrate how some of this works. Here is a folder of some photos. I bought a Jeep 8 or 10 months ago and took a number of photos. Some of these wound up in Apple Photos, but not all of them. You can see some of these aren't particularly interesting photos, but I just saved them until I had a chance to decide what I wanted to do with them. First thing I'm going to do is select most of these and just in a group upload them to Flickr. I'm not going to organize them into individual photos yet. I'm going to get them all up there in the timeline, and then I'm going to come back and show you how the organizational tools can be used to organize your photos. Okay. So here's all the photos that have been selected to upload to Flickr. Now at this point, I could create an album. I could add tags. I could add this to an existing album, but there's 56 photos here. But to we want to use our organizational tools for this little video, so we'll do all of that after the fact. So let's just go ahead and get those 56 photos uploaded. So we're still in the batch organize tab window of Flickr's organizational tools. And if we come down to our timeline, you can see that we have a bunch of new photos here. These are all the photos that we just uploaded. But what we're going to do is we want to not add to an album in this case, but we don't want to create, we're going to create a new album. And let's call it My Jeep. See, in December 2022, I fell in love with an old 1947 CJ2A Jeep. These are a few of the photos from the early days. And we can always go back in and edit that, okay? And now it says drag stuff here to add it to the album. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to select all of these. So the little red X tells you we've got that selected. And let's find the most recent or the last Jeep in this. What did I say? There was 54 of them. So that would be this right here. So you can now see from the, all of these are outlined in red. So they're all selected, so we can just drag them up here. This item, Jeep Tub, that I don't want that in this group. So I can just delete this from the Flickr album. Okay? And it'll be gone. Now you can also, let's see, drag things around. You can put them in the order that you want. You can arrange by the date oldest first, newest first, date uploaded, alphabetically, randomly, reverse current order. Batch edit lets you, if I wanted to, for instance, title all of these My Jeep 2023, I could use that to change all of them. Licensing, I use a Creative Commons license, so I'll probably come back later and do that. Content type, tags. We'll get into tags later, but really useful. I'm a big believer in tags. Here's a picture of Barb and I taking a drive. So Barb and Steve in a Jeep ride. Barb gets her first ride in Steve's new toy. Again, tags. I'm tempted to go into that now. But dates, location, who can see where this photo was taken, anyone. You can put in the latitude and longitude. Filters, not an issue for me, but I mean, you could, if it was a screenshot, you could filter it by that. All kinds of stuff. Let's look at a few tools for organizing that don't require using the batch organizer. So these are the albums I have in my Flickr account, and this most recent one that we just created called My Jeep. If we pull this up, let's go back to the front of the album, and you'll see up here at the top, here's the description, here's the title of the album. But I want to add a little bit more, because over on my blog, I have a lot of posts. I have written a lot, posted a lot about the Jeep, and go into some detail. And one of the categories I created was My Jeep. From the clipboard, I just paste in that URL, and let's say more on my Jeep adventure at. A few more words about titles, descriptions, and tags. Here's a picture of my mechanic, Dan Petkin, after doing some work on the Jeep. And you can see the title is just the default title. It's meaningless. So this really robs the viewer of some interesting information, potentially so. So real easy to fix, and you can just do these one at a time, do them when you have time. But if you don't do them, pretty soon after you upload these, again, you'll never get back to them. So Dan Petkin, behind the wheel. Dan and Chief Mechanic. And again, I could post in a URL to a blog post that I wrote about this particular repair job that they did. So in addition to the photo, there is the option of one clicking through to find out a lot more about the story behind that photo, if there is one. So we clicked on, okay? And let's go to the About page. I like this. This is a place where you tell a Flickr user, or tell people who visit your Flickr account something about you. And I have a bio that I wrote a long time ago, and I update it from time to time. Then there's a place where you can showcase some photos, and I think these are photos that sort of say a little bit about who I think I am. And I mentioned earlier that Flickr launched in February 2004, and I joined just a year later. So I've been with this since almost the beginning. Down here it tells you how many views you've had. We'll come back to tags, geotags. I really don't do much with that. I don't do a lot of faves. But tags are a passion of mine. When you put things in an album, that's sort of a higher order of grouping. And for instance, you can see here some of my tags. Architecture, I've got 36 items. And those could be spread across multiple albums. There are not. I don't have an album called Architecture, and I don't have an album called Art, but I have tagged some of my photos that I want to be able to find again. When you have just one item tagged, that tells you that you really don't need that tag. But tags are really important. My dad and his brother and their father were all in the Navy. I don't have enough photos to warrant a album for Navy, but I've got a lot of photos of 16 photos of my father and his family in their Navy uniforms and so on and so forth. And if I click on that, that pulls up real quick and easy all of the photos that I have tagged thus. So hopefully you're already familiar with the whole concept of tagging, and this little icon here would let me grab this URL and I could share that. I've written a fair amount on my blog about tagging and category, and I may include a link to that here, but that's enough for now on the organizational tools of Flickr.